So this is an omega network of 8 inputs and 8 outputs. Easy, right? This is 8 inputs, 8 outputs, and these are the mappings. Easy, right? You can do it in exams, no problem. Wait, what happened? Feeling what the hell is this? Why is this? Feeling like a spider web? Well, no problem. After 20 minutes, you will feel like it's the easiest thing. Okay, let's get started. Welcome to Smart Study. So here we will study omega network. Before actually drawing the omega network, let's define what's an omega network. So omega network has p number of inputs and outputs. And before drawing omega network, we have to do the mapping. What this I'm going to telling you, but let's write this. Actually, in exam, if you need to draw omega network, you need to remember this one. J is equal to 2i when I is within the range 0 to p by 2 minus 1, and J is 2i plus 1 minus p when I is p between p by 2 and p minus 1. So now you must be thinking, what's I and J? Where I is input and J is output, right? So let's draw an omega network for p equals to 8. So what does p equal to 8 signify? P equal to 8 signify that the omega network has 8 number of inputs and 8 number of outputs. 8 number of inputs and 8 number of outputs, right? So p equal to 8 signifies 8 number of inputs and 8 number of outputs, right? So what are the inputs and outputs? Pretty simple. 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1. Let's write the binary equivalent. It's 0 1 2 and 3 4 5 6 7. So you can see 0 to 7, so 8 inputs. For outputs, similar. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Binary equivalent, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay. So let's do the mapping first. If you can understand this mapping, believe me, omega network is nothing. So to do the mapping, you need to remember this. So as you can see, first let's consider 0. So 0 would be going where? Let's put it, if I is equal to 0, then J will be what? 2 into 0. So J will be also 0. Again repeating, if I is 0, then J will be 2 into 0, 0. Why 2 into 0 and not this? Because I lies between 0 to p by 2 minus 1, I is 0. So I is in this range. So J would be what? 2i. So 2 into 0 is 0. So I equal to 0 will get mapped to J equal to 0, right? So now take I equal to 1. I equal to 1 is in which range? It's in this range, right? So if it is this range, then J would be 2i. So we have taken I 1, so J would be 2. So I would be mapped to 2. Okay. So now I equal to 1 is done. Let's do I equal to 2. So I equal to 2 is 0, I equal to 2 belongs to this range, 0 to p by 2 minus 1, p is 8, so p by 2 y minus 1 is 3, right? 4 by 8 by 2 minus 1, so 2 belongs to 0 to 3 range, that is this range. So j is equal to what? 2 into 2, 4. So 2 will be mapped to 4. Hope you are understanding. Now j is equal to 3. This range is what? 0 to 3, right? So j would be 2i, for I equal to 3. So j would be 6, 2 into 3. So 3 would be mapped to 6, right? Now let's take I equals to 4. I equals to 4 is in which range? Is it this range? No, this is this range, because this is from 0 to 3, right? And this is 4 to 7. If you put p equal to 8, you would get it. It's 4 to 7. So 4 would be going what? 4 would be going j equal to 2 into I plus 1 minus p. So put I equal to 4. 2 into 4 is 8. 8 plus 1 is 9. 9 minus 8 is nothing but 1, right? So for I equal to 4, j is coming 1. So just 4 is going to 1. Okay, so let's put I equal to 5. It's in this range. So I equal to 5 would be 2 into 10, 2 into 5, 10 plus 1, 11, 11 minus 8, 3. So 5 would be mapped to 3. Now put I equal to 6. So j would be 12 plus 1, 13, 13 minus 8, 5. So 6 would be mapped to 5. Now put I equal to 7. 2 into 1, 14 plus 1 minus 8, 15 minus 8 is nothing but 7. So 7 would be mapped to 7. Was it easy or tough? I think it was easy, right? Believe me, you have understood this. Omega network is nothing. So now let's make Omega network. Before making Omega network, remember this. If there are p number of input and outputs, then log p stages will occur. Okay, so p was 8, so log p would be what? 3, right? The base is 2, so there would be 3 rows. Let me make 3 rows. So there will be 3 stages, right? And what are these blocks? These are actually switches, right? They are nothing but 2 cross 2 switches. What does 2 cross 2 switches mean? 2 cross 2 switches mean that each block, that is each switch, will have 2 input and 2 output, right? So if you see, this will be the input side, this will be the output side. So input side will have 8 combinations, 8 inputs, and output side will have 8 outputs, right? So if one switch can contain 2 input, then how many number of blocks will be in the column? 4, right? So there will be 4 such columns, 3 such rows. Log p number of stages and p by 2 number of columns, right? So let me make this. So here it's a structure of Omega network. Now if you have still doubt why there are 4, so let's see why there are 4. Because they are 2 cross 2 switches, so they will have 2 input, 2 output, right? So before drawing anything, let's write the input. First input will be 0, 0, 0. Second will be 0, 0, 1. Third will be 0, 1, 0. Fourth will be 0, 1, 1. Fifth will be 1, 0, 0. Sixth will be 1, 0, 1. Seventh will be 1, 1, 0. Eighth will be 1, 1, 1. Now you realize there will be 4, right? Because each one of will be mapped to the switches. Now, how will the mapping occur? This is the twist. So now, before seeing the mapping, let's do the same thing on the output side. 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 can directly join with them. Yeah, output has no hassle. You can easily join. So output joining is done. Now let's do this thing. So if you remember it, let me two-fold it so you can see it, right? I hope you can see it. So you need to remember this mapping. I am just showing it reference so that you can understand. So 000 is mapped to 0, right? 000. So this will be mapped to this because this is 0, right? 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, in this way it's going. Now this is 001 001 is 1 1 is going to 2, right? So where is 2? 2 is in this block, right? This. So 2 will be mapped like this. Hope you understand, right? 1 was mapped to 2, so this one was mapped to this 2, right? So let's see this. This is what input is 2. So input is 2 means it is going to 4, right? So this is 2. 2 is going to 4. Where is 4? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is this one, right? So let me join it. So 2 is joined to 4, right? In exam, you do it with scales. 2 is joined to 4. Now 3 is joined to 6, right? So where is 6? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 is there. So six is joined, right? Now 0 1 2 3 4 100 4 is joined to 1. So 4 is joined to 1. Where is 1? 1 is there. So let's join it. I know the lines are not straight, but I think you can manage it to understand it, right? You do it with scales, please. I am telling you. So 4 is done and run 5. 101 is 5. 5 is mapping to 3, right? So where is 3? 0, 1, 2, 3. So 5 is mapped to 3, right? Okay. So now 6. 6 is mapped to 5. So 6, where is 5? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is mapped to this, right? So now 7, where is 7? 7 is mapped to 7, so no problem. 7 is mapped to 7. Now visualize this, that this whole set of input is just copied into this. You need not write this in exams. And not on this side. This is copied into this. This is copied into this, and so on. You just need to visualize it, right? So let's do it. So where was this? Is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so on. So this 0 was mapped to 0, right? So let's join this 0. Where was 1? 1 was mapped to 2. So 0, 1, 2. So 1 was mapped to 2. So 0, 1 and now 2, right? 2 was mapped to 4. So 0, 1, 2. 2 was mapped to 4, right? So let's do it. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. 2 is now mapped to 4. Where is 3? 3 is mapped to 6. 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's do it. 3 is mapped to 6. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now 4. Where is 4? 4 is here. 4 is mapped to 1. So 4 is here. 4 is mapped to 1. Now 5. Where is 5? 5 is being mapped to 3. 5 is being mapped to 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. So 5 is being mapped to 3. Now 6. 6 is being mapped to 5, right? So 6 is being mapped to 5. And 7. 7 has no hassle, easily join with this 7. And as I have told, this one is copied into this, this and this. So for this side, same thing will go. 0 will be joined. 0, 1, where will be 1? 1 will be joined to 0, 1, 2, this 2. 2, right? 0, 1, 2. Now 2 will be joined to 4. If I'm not wrong, yes. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 2 will be joined to 4. And now 3. 3 will be joined to 6. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? So 3 will be joined to 6. Okay. Now 4. 4 will be joined to 1. 4 will be joined to 1. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's join it. Is joined to 1. Now 5. 5 will be joined to 3. Yes. 0, 1, 2, 3. So 5 will be joined to 3. Now 6. 6 will be joined to 5. Yes. So 6 will be joined to 5. And 7 will be, 7 has no hassle, so 7 will be easily joined to 7. Now believe it or not, Omega network is done. Yes, this is Omega network. So Omega network connecting 8 inputs and 8 outputs. So this is our Omega network. Pretty easy, right? So hope you understood it. So for prerequisite, you need to learn this mapping, and remembering this, you can easily place it into this. So now if you are motivated enough, you can do 16 input and 16 output combination. It's a favorite question for computer architecture. Most of the time it's given in the exam, so you can do it. Even if you don't do it, on my next presentation I will do an Omega network containing 16 input and 16 output, and there will be an additional problem, an extension of Omega network, and we will also do that. So if you have now learned how to do Omega network, then give this video a like, share it with your friends so that they can also do it pretty easily. Yeah, have a great day.